James Madison is going to leave us a very, very authentic and well-crafted record of what happened at that convention. And I think it's also appropriate to point out the fact that we are here in the Commonwealth, and again, that this is the best place to have a discussion on this particular issue. And unfortunately, we are in such a situation today where we have a U.S. Congress that does assume that it operates as supreme law. We also know that we have an executive administration that is most unfortunately bent on pursuing an economic leveling of life here in the United States. And I think the message that I have for you today, and I do hope it doesn't appear to be too academic and too pedantic, that I am a lover of liberty, I believe in scholarship, and I believe that we are the best guardians of our liberty. And I want to make certain that you are well equipped to become a scholar and a student of your own liberties. And I'm going to go ahead and try and move through the slides from that laptop back there and move up here on my laptop. And if it just so happens that there is a disconnection between them, I have somebody that will let me know that, okay? Well, let's go ahead and consider to be the very clause less liable to misconstruction. And we find that the very nature of that misconstruction today has eroded our liberties. And so I want to make certain that you understand what this clause said. So what I've basically done is I've thrown it up here at the top and I've underlined some of those very, very salient areas that I want you to consider. And I've deliberately taken it out of context. And one of the questions that I enjoy asking my students and asking individuals that I get a chance to actually talk to about this particular issue is, what does general welfare mean and what does common defense mean? And we must always keep it in context. And so here we have, the Congress shall have N excises. And it's important to notice that there's a comma right after excises. To pay the debts and provide for the common defense and general welfare of the United States. And then there's a semicolon. But all duties imposed in excises shall be uniform throughout the United States. And so this is the capstone to the next series of enumerated powers that subsequently follow. And I think today, the issue that you and I have to confront head-on, and I try to actually tease out some of the main guidelines here, is the province of congressional authority. That is, how far can Congress actually go in its legislative capacity or function? And this is the question of jurisdiction. And so we have here really two options in light of this particular clause. Either it is a limitation upon congressional taxing and spending authority, or it's an unlimited grant of congressional taxing and spending authority. If the first is indeed the case, then we have the authority to pay the debts and provide for the common defense and general welfare. If it's not, then Congress now has discretion to decide what the common defense and general welfare is. If the text isn't law, if the Constitution is not law, then Congress will have the authority to make this determination. So these are the two options that we have.